Welcome to Graya Overload. I'm Anthony, and Spectre and Meltdown have been out for publicly for about a week. I want to kind of go through some of the updates that have happened over this last week, as well as kind of take a look at some of the updates that we've already had and we are expecting here going forward. Spectre and Meltdown made it a very interesting week with CES being at the same time that it was being announced. So there's a lot of industry leaders there having to go through and reiterate on Spectre and Meltdown and basically give statements on it. So there's more information that came out overall. I want to first go through and clarify a little bit what AMD said. AMD said that first they had just added on to what they had priorly said. So Spectre Variant 1, like they said before, they believe can be mitigated through an OS update, and they're working with Microsoft to distribute the patch as well as working with Linux vendors to roll out the patch right now. Spectre Variant 2, they had more of an update on. Now, they had before said that there was a near zero way to for this to happen. They believe that there was a near zero way Spectre Variant 2 was able to be executed on their processors, and now they've worked even close with the industry about the threat, and now they're also going to issue OS updates and a microcode update for their CPUs to further mitigate the issue even further. So there was a little more update on there. AMD is taking more steps to further mitigate it, as well as working with, you know, OS and providers as well to help with that mitigation here. So that's a good sign. So I basically see it as it's taking a near zero risk to almost, I mean, zero, closer to zero. I mean, something like that. So I see it as they're getting as close to zero as possible. And that's an encouragement that AMD is taking those steps as well. And they said that microcoders for the CPUs should be rolling out for Ryzen and Epic starting this week. Also, then they said with Meltdown, they still do not believe that AMD processors are susceptible due to the privilege level protections within paging architecture. So no mitigation is required. And that's a little bit on AMD's update to what has been happening with Spectre and Meltdown. Then Intel came out. They're still working on all these things, Spectre and Meltdown. First thing was that they said that by January 15th, 90% of Intel CPUs within the past 5 years should have an update ready for them, or an update issued out for them at least. So I'm monitoring all the CPUs that I have to just overall just to see where these updates are coming out. Now you have to wait for, you know, to maybe go through another manufacturer, like, you know, if you have a computer, to go through there before you would get it. But you know, that's going out there right now. I'm watching it just to see where this is all going. But you know, one thing Intel is doing, and that's their second thing with security, is that they're transparent and timely communications. Almost every day, every other day, they're having a communication out on the Spectre Meltdown, regards to performance, where they're at, how they're doing. They even gave one where their firmwares were for Haswell and Broadwell processors were doing reboots, so that they're already addressing that as well. So they've been on their communication. I've been very impressed with it, and I've been happy and pleased with it. So I'm glad they're going through that well of communication, and we'll see what other industry people do as well. But Intel's doing a lot of updates, which is very good at this point. And then Intel also, with their security pledge, is saying that, hey, we're going to have ongoing security insurance. And you know what? I hope you're always having ongoing security insurance. I mean, it's important in basically all industries now, especially software and hardware. There's lots of things going on, and you just have to work at it all the time. You know, it's a fun industry to be in, but it also can be trying at times, right? So I think there's more opportunity for more security people out there now. So if you're looking, you have an opportunity for more security stuff. But Intel's going to be working with industry leaders, etc., to help that go forward here. But like I mentioned here, a little bit about the OS updates. Microsoft was having an issue with updating with some AMD processors. Now, if that was you, hopefully that you found a workaround or was able to uninstall the patch to get your computer back up and running. But overall, I think AMD here and Microsoft are working hard to make sure that that gets back up and running and all the patches get pushed out. So we'll see in basically the coming week to and coming weeks maybe how that's all going. And I'm pretty sure that Microsoft's probably going to clean up things, put more into the patch overall through updates just to make sure that the computers are more secure and that it fully mitigates some of these Spectre variants as well. So it'll be very interesting to see that going forward, and I will be keeping track of it. Hopefully there's no major issues, but we never know here. The microcode updates are going to be interesting. That's something to watch out for as well. Intel was already starting to issue those. They had, like I mentioned, some reboots, and that's going to be interesting. Intel seems to be faster addressing this, but with all the code updates and microcode updates and stuff, firmware updates that they need to do, it's a lot of work going on right now, and it has got to be fun over there in these in OS processor places everywhere. So I know ARM's working hard on it. Apple just issued an update for iOS as well to make sure that was 11.2.2 with the latest updates and stuff and everything there with regarding with Spectre and Meltdown. If I believe both were applicable there, I'm not exactly sure, but they're working at it as well. So everyone in the industry has been working hard. It seems like that they were trying to make sure everything's getting out. It's going to be interesting to see. One thing we're going to have to pay attention to going forward, I think, is all the security. And if something else pops up, how's this all going to react? How far are companies willing to go back to patch their processors? I think that's a big thing too. And to see where we're basically at for all the security updates and where everything's going to be, right? To make sure you're patched and everything else. I think that there's Microsoft and everyone's releasing tools to see if you're affected. So it's going to be really interesting to see. Performance data, I think, is another big one. Intel's came out and talked about some performance data, and that I don't think it's going to really affect the everyday user. Like most stuff I do, well, some stuff I do during the day, I don't think it's going to affect it overall. I think my wife is more workflow. It's not going to really affect my workflow. It's going to be more impactful, development and everything else, software development, I should say. And that, I think, especially working on some server-side systems, I've already seen certain slowdowns. But for the everyday person, just a normal workflow, I don't think there's going to be there. I'm really interested to see everything on that server side, what's going to happen, and how, a little bit might affect the server market in somewhat as well. I know Red Hat, Microsoft, Intel have given numbers on what they expect slowdowns. I think I've heard up to like 18% and down to 6% on Intel for some stuff. I mean, for the high end of that. And so it'll be interesting. I'm sure a lot of stuff is going to be minimal, but it's a wait and see here to see as it goes going forward. But it's going to be interesting to watch. I will be keeping tabs on it, and I hopefully that you can get your system patched and secure as best as possible here in the short term, and keep up to date as best you can. So with that, I want to thank you for watching. Thank you for supporting Gray Overload and continue to help this channel grow. And until next time, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching Gray Overload. If you like this content, be sure to subscribe.